السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. أما بعد, brothers and sisters, this will be the episode where we talk about one of Allah's beautiful names. We will continue talking about it in the next episode, and then we will conclude our series about understanding Allah's beautiful names. And before we conclude it in the next two episodes, I would like to tell you, thank you very much. Wallahi, thank you from the bottom of my heart that you have entrusted me with your time to understand Allah's beautiful names so we can share this moment, bi-idhnillah, a moment of barakah, where we will see the reward of this in the dunya and the akhirah. Ameen, Rabbil Alameen. Thank you, thank you, thank you. With me thanking you so much, what do you think will be the last name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we will talk about in this series? It is Allah's beautiful name, Ash-Shakur. Allah, the most thankful. Allah, the most appreciative. Now, what does Shakur mean? Shakur, brothers and sisters, from a linguistic perspective, is Al-Kathra wa-Ziyada, increase and excess. For example, they would say, this land is Shakur. This land is Shakur. What does it mean? It means that this land, you put little water, you put a little sunlight towards it, and it gives you a lot of vegetation. They would say, for example, this baqara is shakur. This baqara is very shakur, which means, oh, this cow is shakur. What do they mean? That this cow gives a lot of milk when we only feed it a little bit. Now, Allah is the best of examples. What does it mean when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a shakur? It means He's the one who appreciates the little that you do by giving you that which is so big. Allah is shakur, is the one who gives you for the little that you do a very, very big thing. So inshallah, we're going to go through several points to show you how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is shakur in this life and in the afterlife. Number one, from a date to a mountain. What does that mean? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't forget to say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, al-abdu al-mu'minu yatasaddaqu bit-tamrati aw adlaha min at-tayyib fala yaqbalu Allahu illa at-tayyib. That a slave of Allah who is a believer gives in donation a date from a halal resource, and Allah only accepts that which is halal. فَتَقَعُوا فِي يَدِ اللَّهِ. So this sadaqah is placed in the hands of Allah in a way that befits Allah's majesty. Is it clear? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will continue to grow it and grow it and grow it حَتَّى يَصِيرَ مِثْلَ التَّلِّ الْعَظِيمِ. Until this date that you donated, just this one date, Allah will allow it to be as a magnificent mountain, a massive one, subhanAllah. So all what you've given is a date, but Allah appreciated. Allah tells you, thank you. We thank you so much for that small thing that you gave. And the way Allah thanks you is by giving you so, so much. Is it clear? Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا. Don't ever, ever, ever belittle a good deed. Never. وَلَوْ أَن تَلْقَ أَخَاكَ بِوَجْهٍ طَلِقٍ. Even if that one good deed is for you to meet your brother and sister with a smile. Don't belittle the influence of a smile. Don't belittle that, for that's the behavior of the Muslim. We don't look down upon any good deed. Is it clear? Can you imagine that brother or that sister who donated that date and would go yawm al-qiyamah, and the angels say, oh, you see all these mountains? These are reward for you for the date. You're like, maybe there's a mistake because I only give one date, and this mountain is maybe for those who donated a mountain weight of dates. They say, no, Allah al-Shakur, appreciate that date, and He has given you this. SubhanAllah. Brothers and sisters, Allah is al-Shakur. Wallahi, this is a name that should motivate us. Had you ever been lazy to do something that which is good in the deen? Had you been lazy to do a da'wah project? Wallahi, al-Shakur is the name you're looking for to motivate you, to pump you up, that Allah will appreciate it in a way that you've never imagined. SubhanAllah. Let's say we have a fundraising dinner, for example, khalas, and people, they want some support to the masjid. And someone comes and says, you know what, I have $1 for you. I have $1 for you. The masjid is going to cost $1 million. You're going to have $1? People might look down upon that person. Like, really, you're making a scene out of $1. That's all you can afford. What can this do to us? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appreciates that $1 so much beyond how much we can think. Point number two, I'll give you an example of how Allah appreciates. Whenever you help someone break their fast, you get the reward of their fasting without their fasting being diminished in terms of reward to them. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من فطر صائما فله مثل أجره. Whoever breaks the fasting of some other person, Allah will reward them as if they did the fasting. Wallahi, this is very beautiful. And I just realized, as I'm saying this hadith, I remembered actually a story as I was, it's not in my notes. There was a brother who would run around in the masjid in my city, local city, during Maghrib time, with a box of dates, running. Please take this date. Please take this. He's begging us, subhanAllah. And I just remembered when I read this hadith, مَنْ فَطَّرَ صَائِمًا فَلَهُ مِثْلُ أَجْرِهِ, because he knows that Allah appreciates the good acts that we do. Imagine you were eating all day, just a regular day. Khalas, on Monday, you're just eating, drinking, enjoying your day. You know if a person was fasting, you gave him a date, you gave him some food, that person breaks their fast because of your food, you will get reward as if you fast on Monday. Allahu Akbar, wallahi, it's unbelievable. But Allah appreciates in ways we don't imagine. You know why? Because His name is Ash-Shakur. Even if the good that was done is not done to human beings, it was done to animals. Na'am. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, بَيْنَمَا رَجُلٌ يَمْشِي بِطَرِيقٍ اشْتَدَّ عَلَيْهِ الْعَطَشِ. When a man was walking on a path where he became so thirsty, and it happened that when that person saw that well, he goes down the well, he drank some of the water. Then he left the well, فَإِذَا كَلْبٌ يَلْهَثُ. He saw a dog that was so thirsty, doing the whatever, the tongue going out, etc., showing the signs that that dog is really, really thirsty. And to the extent that that dog was licking the sand. This man said, لَقَدْ بَلَغَ هَذَا الْكَلْبِ مِنَ الْعَطَشِ مِثْلُ الَّذِي كَانَ بَلَغَ بِي. This dog, apparently he's so thirsty, just like I was thirsty. So that man said, you know what, I'm going to go down the well, get him water. فَنَزَلَ الْبِئْرَ فَمَلَأَ خُفَّهُ. So he went down, filled up his shoes, then went all the way up and gave the water. فَسَقَ الْكَلْبِ. Gave the water to the dog, and the dog drank from the water. What happened? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in an authentic hadith, فَشَكَرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ. Allah appreciated that. فَغَفَرَ لَهُ. And Allah forgave him for all his sins. Isn't this unbelievable? We work so hard to get our sins forgiven, and this man simply gives some water to a dog, the dog drinks it, Allah forgives all of his sins. SubhanAllah. You know why? Because Allah is a shakur. Allah is a shakur, brothers and sisters. The people of the Sahaba told Rasulullah, وَإِنَّ لَنَا فِي الْبَهَائِمِ أَجْرًا. We get rewarded when we do good to animals. Then Rasulullah said, فِكُلِّ ذَاتِ كَبِدٍ. For every living thing you do good to them, Allah will appreciate, Allah will reward you for it. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, this is not just for the righteous. This is not just for the brother who appears, perhaps he might be a practicing brother, but even for the prostitute. The worst occupation a woman can ever do in her life, which is doing prostitution. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in an authentic hadith, بَيْنَمَا كَلْبٌ يَطِيفُ بِرِكْيَةٍ قَدْ كَادَ يَقْتُلُهُ الْعَطَشُ. When there was a dog walking around a well, and that dog was so thirsty, a woman, إِذْ رَأَتْهُ بَغِيٌّ مِنْ بَغَايَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ. One of the prostitutes from Bani Israel, she saw this. She was very touched. فَنَزَعَتْ. What happened is that she took off her scarf. Then she attached it to her shoes. Then she put the scarf, the shoes in the bi'r. And then she made sure that the shoes is filled with water. She pulled all the way up, then gave it to the dog. فَسَقَتْهُ إِيَّاهَا. What did Allah do? Before I move on, I'll tell you what did Allah do. If this happens in our time, if you witness something like that, or maybe if someone else witnessed it, maybe not you, maybe someone else, with not very good manners. Mashallah, you are very well-mannered, inshallah. And he says, oh, you munafiqah, you prostitute, you think Allah will reward you for giving water to the dog? Are you serious? Go change your life first before you do good to the animals. Do good to your own self first. Or someone would say, oh, what do you think you're doing? You're going to Jahannam anyways. You're a prostitute. What are you doing? But Allah is different. Allah is a shakur. Allah will appreciate what she did, even though she's a prostitute. Even though most people on the face of this earth may not even appreciate what she did, but Allah appreciates. And you know what Allah did? فَغَوْفِرَ لَهَا بِهِ. Allah forgave all of her sins because she gave the dog some water. I ask a question. When your mom asks you for a cup of water and you give it to your mom, what would Allah do? To what extent will Allah appreciate? If a prostitute gave a dog that, then what about you or righteous brother or sister? You give a cup of water to your mom. Just think about it. Can you please, every single time your mom asks you to do something or your dad asks you to do something, you rush for it and remember this hadith for me? And remember this hadith for me, please? Remember that Allah will appreciate whatever you do. Please, remember that and never forget. Is it clear? So inshallah, we'll go for a break and then we'll continue with more things to encourage you to go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-Shakur. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you and honor you. Jazakum Allahu khaira wa barakallahu feekum. Stay tuned. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm Yusuf Estes and you're watching Peace TV.
Every human being can agree to disagree or disagree to agree. Dispute superstitions and refute the myth which is created around the word religion, which is misinterpreted, misconstrued, and misjudged. Let's wake up from delusion. And step into the world of reality with confidence. Find all the answers to confront or defy, reject or accept, dispute or challenge. When caught in crossfire,
Misconceptions clarified, falsehood exposed, and truth revealed. Discover the reality with Dr. Zakir Naik in Crossfire. Every Friday at 8:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 10 a.m. Saudi Arabia on Peace TV.
Muhammad, pearls of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Narrated Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him. The Prophet, may peace be upon him, said, there are two blessings which many people lose. They are health and free time for doing good. Sahih al-Bukhari, Volume 8, Book of Softening of Hearts, Hadith number 6412.
Students of Islamic International School showcase on eve of the IIS Annual Day event.
Welcome you to the grand finale of Islamic International School.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Performances par excellence, recitations soul stirring.
Man finds means for momentary pleasure when I am with him and goes astray.
They are the enemy. So beware of them.
This is the summary of our carried out expenses this month.
And don't you forget who's the boss. Oh, yeah?
Watch these cool kids impress and uplift your hearts, your minds, and your iman.
With Allah's help, this will be a memorable event.
Wiz Kids. Next on Peace TV.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you very much for your patience. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make you among those people that are patient in the dunya and you get the reward of that in the akhirah. Ameen rabbil alameen. Thank you once again. I'm going to keep telling you thank you throughout the talk because we're talking about Allah al-Shakur and how Allah appreciates. So we too have to appreciate what the good the people do. I ask a question. When your mom asks you for a cup of water and you give it to your mom, what would Allah do? To what extent will Allah appreciate? If a prostitute gave a dog that, then what about you or righteous brother or sister, you give a cup of water to your mom? Just think about it. Can you please, every single time your mom asks you to do something or your dad asks you to do something, you rush for it and remember this hadith for me? And remember this hadith for me, please? Remember that Allah will appreciate whatever you do. Please, remember that and never forget. Is it clear? We mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-Shakur is the one who gives you for the little that you do a very massive thing. And I'm going to continue inshallah with a few more ahadith to show you how Allah appreciates. He even appreciates it when you withhold from doing that which is haram. Wallahi, every time we talk about this beautiful thing, Allah al-Shakur, it's just amazing. Allah appreciates it when you're about to do something that is haram, you stop, Allah rewards you for it. Thank you for not doing it. Subhanallah. Can you imagine someone, for example, wants to cheat in an exam? So he or she was about to cheat, then they said, you know what? I will not cheat. But the teacher saw them, that they were about to cheat, and then they retreated. But the teacher says, you know what? I'll give you bonus marks. It doesn't even make sense, right? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-Shakur is the best of examples. He appreciates. What's the hadith? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and don't forget to say, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَتَبَ الْحَسَنَاتِ وَالسَّيِّئَاتِ فَمَنْ هَمَّ بِحَسَنَةٍ فَلَمْ يَعْمَلْهَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَهُ عِنْدَهُ حَسَنَةً كَامِلَةً. Whoever was about to do a good deed and they don't end up doing it, Allah will reward them as if they've done it. Then the hadith continues, وَإِنْ عَمِلَهَا, and if that person does it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will multiply the reward at least by 10 times to 700 times or more than that, whatever Allah wills. And then the hadith continues, the third and last part. وَمَنْ هَمَّ بِسَيِّئَةٍ فَلَمْ يَعْمَلْهَا, and whoever was about to do a sayyi'ah and they did not end up doing it, pay attention, they're about to do a sayyi'ah and they did not end up doing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what happened? كَتَبَهَا اللَّهُ لَهُ عِنْدَهُ حَسَنَةً كَامِلَةً. Huh? Allah will reward them with a complete hasana just for leaving that one haram. فَإِنْ عَمِلَهَا كَتَبَهَا اللَّهُ سَيِّئَةً وَاحِدَةً. And if they did do that haram, then Allah will write it for them as if they've done one sin, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah appreciates it by giving you the hasana that you've done, multiply by 10 to 700 to much more. And had you been about to do a bad sin or haram, Allah will appreciate it if you don't do it by rewarding you a full entire hasana. This point number 6, beautiful point. Allah even appreciates your intention. So even if there's no action taken, Allah will appreciate your intention being there. Look at this hadith where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا الدُّنْيَا لِأَرْبَعَةِ نَفَرِ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا الدُّنْيَا لِأَرْبَعَةِ نَفَرِ. There are four groups of people in this dunya. And me and you, we are in one of four. Is it clear? And check yourself, which one are you in? Number one, Rasulullah ﷺ says, the first group, عَبْدٍ رَزَقَهُ اللَّهُ مَالًا وَعِلْمًا. The first group, Allah has given them money and knowledge. So what did he do with it? فَهُوَ يَتَّقِي فِيهِ رَبَّهُ وَيَصِلُ فِيهِ رَحِمَهُ. So with that money and knowledge, they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they support their ties of kinship. وَيَعْلَمُ لِلَّهِ فِيهِ حَقًّا. And that person does what